lot of things that I do, and as a cultural educator, I'm a storyteller, and I'm also, as I said, I work in a school, Grafton Job Corp. I actually work with teenagers, but they act like you guys as well, so I understand everybody kind of acts the same, and I love what I do working with youth. And these are a couple of the books that I wrote, and for all you kids back there waving money at me, don't worry, it's okay. They're over there. You can still buy one. So I actually have a third book as well. It's not here today, The Morning Road to Thanksgiving. This is my newest book, and some of the stories I'm going to share today are actually in this book entitled Drumming and Dreaming. And I think I'm starting to hear something. I think all this drumming woke up Rosie. Rosie, are you awake? I'm sorry, I was just singing. What? The kids wanted to hear the drum. What? Okay, do you want to see the kids? All right. Rosie. Rosie wanted to see you guys. Oh, Rosie. You want to say hi to Rosie? Rosie! No! Hey! Hey, Rosie! What over here? Oh, Rosie! No! 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 No, they don't have tomato juice and vinegar. I'm sorry. Give it a couple weeks and it'll come off. I apologize. Rosie, you are, can't take her anywhere. Oh, my goodness. What? Rosie just wanted to make sure you guys are paying attention. So I see you are. It's water. I can tell you that. I did that somewhere and I had a parent come after me with a broomstick because I thought it was a real skunk juice. So I got to make sure I finish that bit, that it's water, so the kids don't come after me. So, as you see, I like to have a lot of fun in what I do, and sharing stories is something that I truly enjoy doing. And now that you met Rosie, any questions so far about what I shared? Any questions? Okay. I think I'm going to start with a story. Now, before I tell this story, you need to understand that the stories are, and everywhere I go when I tell stories, I see, which I'm very pleased, lots of young faces. But the stories are for the big and the young, because they're school, they're life lessons, they're university education about living and dying. Every story that a native child hears is teaching them how to live, how to survive, self-discipline, and but Native people were very creative and funny and spontaneous, so the stories are very fun. And you like I say, as a writer, I like to teach people by accident. So I slip in the education without them knowing, because people don't like to learn. They don't want academic books that are boring stuff. But if you're getting entertained and you're hearing all these things, you kind of pick up on it. So Native stories are very important for that matter. And also, we do just tell them just to have fun. Kind of like this story I'm going to share now. So, who's man's best friend? Anybody? Can anybody tell me that?
A dog?
Yes, a dog. Man.
A man? Who's this young man in the back? What did he say? A man?
Yeah. So you know the thing about what a man's best friend is?
Yeah.
It could go the other way around.
Okay, but for the story, it's going to be a dog. Okay. Man's best friend is a dog. Now, can you guys talk to dogs like the way I'm talking to you?
No.
Well, in the ancient lands that I'm come from, which is right here where you are sitting today, we used to be able to speak to dogs, just like you and I are talking right now. We spoke their language and they spoke ours. When you hear the stories about how Native people were connecting with the land and the animals, it was true! We did it! Yes, it happened. So, but as times changed and people began thinking more about themselves and less about the land and the animals, the separation began to drift. And soon the dog would talk like this, and hi, how you doing, human being? And you're messing up the land, and we didn't want to hear it. You're destroying the land, but it sounded like this. Roo, 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 roo. Stop destroying the water. Roo, roo. Stop poisoning. Stop making litter. Stop being greedy. And all we heard was roo, roo, roo. And they still try to tell us today. So, anyways, you got to rewind. We got to go back to the beginning. And this story takes place in the village of the dogs, because the dogs have a community just like us human beings do, the trees and the bears. They all have their own village. So there was this little doggy village, and there's this puppy. And he was asking his mom about the old days. And the puppy said to his mom, what did he say? And he can't remember. He said, Mom, how come we can't talk to the human beings anymore? Why all they hear is barks? How come we can't talk to them anymore? The little puppy asked. And the mom replied, because those human beings, they're crazy and greedy. There's no good in them. We gotta stay away. And the puppy said, but Mom, I wanna talk like a human being. No, puppy, you need to stop that. We're not talking to those human beings anymore. It's been a separation, it's gonna stay there. Do you understand? Oh, Mom, yes, Mom, okay. Yeah, whose mom sounds like that? Anybody? There's a mom back there. Hi, Raina. So, as the story went on, the little puppy, he went about his business and he went with his friends and so on. But then something happened. The mommy and daddy doggies, and all of them in the village, had a very important meeting to go to. And as they left, they put the teenager puppies in charge of the little puppies. So all the mommies and daddies, they left the village and left all the little puppies there. And bye-bye, we got big dog business to take care of, whatever that was. Nobody really remembers. So they all left, and then all those puppies were there just kind of hanging out. The big teenagers there, probably teasing them as well, right? You know how teenagers are. So anyways, that little puppy dog, there he was again with his little puppy friend there. He says, you know, I didn't like what my mom said about not talking to human beings. I think we could speak it like human beings. Well, sure we could. And his friend said, man, you're crazy. You gotta let that go. I mean, look at you. You're walking around on all fours. Human beings, they walk on two legs. They're walking around like that. And we're walking around. So the puppy said, yeah, you know what? Well, I'm gonna stand up like a human being. So the little puppy jumped up. He fell back down. He jumped up and fell back down. And all the other puppies saw it. They were laughing. Oh, look at him. He's crazy. And so his friend didn't like them making fun of him. He says, huh, all right. He said, okay, friend, jump up again. So just as the little puppy jumped up, his friend jumped up at the same time with him. And they locked arms. And now they're holding each other up just like that. The little puppies are holding it. And then all the other puppies saw that too. He said, hey, we want to try that. So then all the other puppies, they paired up and they all jumped up and locked hands. They had all these little puppies standing around, they were like kind of square dancing. If you're an Indian, you're round dancing. So they were all kind of doing this and dancing. They looked really cute, all these little puppies holding each other up. Oh, man. So then the puppy again said, he said, well, wait a minute. Now we're standing up like human beings, but what about these tails? Human beings don't have tails. He said, yeah, you're right. You're right, they don't have tails. So the little puppy said, wait a minute. He reached behind, boom, pulled his tail off, and threw it in the middle of the circle. And then, when he did that, all the other puppies did, boop, 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 boop. Yeah, I would have laughed too. So all the little puppies pulled their tails off. And now they're dancing around, they got no tail, now they kind of look like people. You probably know somebody who looks like them. And they're dancing around like that, and they're moving. And then, no tail, they're standing up and they're dancing around, having a good time, but, oh no! The parents were on their way back, to their surprise. The little puppies panicked. So they said, oh no, we gotta stop acting like human beings. So all the puppies at the same time dove into that pile of tails, but they were all grabbing the wrong tail. The brown dog grabbed the white tail, the white dog grabbed the black tail, the black dog grabbed the beige tail, and so on. It was a mess. Every dog put on the wrong tail. Oh no. And you know what happened because of that? Even today, there's still a problem because of that. All the doggies have the wrong tail. So, whenever a dog sees another dog, the first thing it does to it goes up behind him and sniffs. Is that my tail? That's the story. I'll say that again. When the puppy sees another puppy, goes up behind him and looks at his tail and says,